like you. Your mission is to gather data about the Romulan leadership. In essence, we want you to take the pulse of their government. No pun intended.
You want me to spy on an ally?
To evaluate an ally. And a temporary ally at that. Now, I say that because when the war is over, the following will happen in short order. The Dominion will be forced back to the Gamma Quadrant. The Cardassian Empire will be occupied. The Klingon Empire will spend the next 10 years recovering from the war and won't pose a serious threat to anyone. That leaves two powers to vie for control of the Quadrant. The Federation and the Romulans.
This war isn't over. And you're already planning for the next.
Well put. I hope your report is equally succinct.
How many times do I have to tell you, Sloane? I don't work for you.
You will. It's in your nature. You are a man who loves secrets. Medical, personal, fictional. And I am a man of secrets. You want to know what I know. And the only way to do that is to accept the assignment.
Checked all the security locks. There's no indication of how Sloane got aboard or where he went.
I can't say I'm surprised. From what we've seen of them, Section 31 is very meticulous in covering its tracks. I had a conversation with Admiral Ross this afternoon. He and I both agree that the Romulan conference is too important to cancel.
What about me?
Starfleet commanders promised to send the expert on Dominion biogenic weapons and Cutrasel White to the conference. Since that's you, you go. And we want you to carry out your assignment. Make a few discreet observations on the Romulan leadership, and then wait for Sloane to contact you again.
Somehow, I don't think giving Sloane any information is a good idea.
That was my instinct as well. But after talking to Ross, I think we might have an opportunity here we can turn to our advantage. Officially, Starfleet Command has said that they are appalled at the very notion that an organization like Section 31 might exist, and that they plan to get to the bottom of this entire business.
And unofficially?
They have quietly pushed the investigation aside, which means either they don't take Section 31 seriously, or someone at Starfleet Command is protecting them. Either way, we now have a chance to get someone inside, and I think I want to take it.
So you want me to play along? Pretend that I've decided to work for Sloane after all?
Exactly. When he contacts you to find out what you learned at the conference, make it seem like you've reluctantly come around to his way of thinking. Let him believe that he has seduced you into helping him.
Well, that shouldn't be too difficult. Sloane thinks I'm already so tempted that I barely can see straight. Well, listen, I better pack. The Bellerophon leaves in 3 hours.
One more thing, Doctor. Remember, this isn't a game. Section 31 is very dangerous. If Sloane even suspects that you are really working for us...
I understand.
Good hunting.
Glass of Romulan ale, Doctor?
Thank you, Senator.
The trading embargo has been officially lifted, if you were wondering.
It hadn't crossed my mind, actually.
To one of the many benefits of the Alliance.
Need a medical team, sir?
No, thank you.
Don't tell me this is your first glass of Romulan ale.
Well, it was illegal.
That never stopped most of your colleagues.
I know. I was probably one of the few officers in the fleet who didn't indulge occasionally.
Would you like something else?
No, I'll manage.
That's the spirit, so never say die.
What an odd expression. What does it mean?
It's a line from an old Earth poem. Forgive me for interrupting. I couldn't help overhearing, and etymology is one of my hobbies. The phrase, never say die, is originally from a 19th century poem based on Shakespeare's Merchant of Venice.